What's good, you all? It's the one and only Omar Fina, the most phenomenal voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go subscribe to the phenomenal crew. Now let's get to it. Listen, shout out to Leon Rose, shout out to Scott Perry, shout out to Tom Thibodeau, shout out to the Knicks front office as a whole. The past 3 weeks, combined with the draft and free agency, has been amazing. As a Knicks fan, if you're a Knicks fan right now, if you one of my fellow Knicks fans, you gotta feel excited, man. The future is bright. The future is bright in New York. The future is bright in the Garden. This is the most excited I've been for the future of the Knicks since Melo's been here. Since the last time we traded for Melo and brought in Amari Stoudemire, listen, I haven't been this excited for a Knicks team since that Melo Amari Stoudemire era. Real talk. Hear me out, y'all. I had to come on here and give y'all the truth because I know so many people in the national media right now is probably bugging out about the Knicks about why we didn't get this player and why we didn't get this and why we didn't get that and why we went out and signed Michael Gilchrist and he can't shoot and we don't got any stars. Listen, hear me out. It's a process. It's a fucking process. And right now, Leon Rose is doing a hell of a job getting a process going. This is how a rebuilding process goes. A good rebuilding process. For the past, 20 years, we've been trying to get star free agents to come to the Garden. It has never worked. At the end of the day, we got the future of New York sports and RJ Barrett. We got the best young defending big man in the NBA, Mitchell Robinson. And we just traded for the top three player. We just drafted a top three player in the draft. And Obi Toppin. At the end of the day, the future is bright in New York. And at the end of the day, people are, like I said, they complain. And listen, New York is going to complain. It's just what New Yorkers do. I complain. But at the end of the day, this is the best offseason that we had in forever. I mean, my goodness. At the end of the day, y'all, we went out. We got a top three player in the draft. Pairing him up with RJ Money Mitch. And then we went out and got a lot of high quality free agents for low prices in the free agency. At the end of the day, going out and signing Nerlens Noel for a cheap contract for $5 million is a good move. Going out and signing Austin Rivers for 3 years, only $10 million, is a good move. Nerlens Noel, he brings a defense. You guys, listen, we are starting to finally have an identity in the Garden. And that's what we've been lacking for forever. We never had an identity. Now we get an identity. We brought in Tom Thibodeau, one of the best defensive head coaches for the past 2 decades. I mean, for real, outside of Greg Popovich, who's been a better defensive coach than Tom Thibodeau for the past decade? I mean, for real, who's a better defensive head coach than Tom Thibodeau for the past 2 decades? This guy, I mean, everybody speaks about Doc Rivers. I mean, yes, Doc Rivers was the head coach of that 2018. But let's not forget that Tom Thibodeau played a huge part of getting that defense right on that 2008 Boston Celtics team when they were rolling out Kevin Garnett, Paul Pierce, Ray Allen, and the crew. So it's like, at the end of the day, y'all, we got our head coach. We got a solidified, proven head coach. We have a young player, the future of our organization, RJ Barrett. We got the face of the franchise, RJ Barrett. We got another young player that's going to be on the squad for the next 10 years of Money Mitch. At the end of the future is there. We just went out and got the best two-way wing in the draft in Obi Toppin. And, listen, some people are saying that Obi Toppin, he's a power forward / center. I had a little conversation, a little debate with one of my homeboys about Obi Toppin. At the end of the day, how I look at Obi Toppin is, I think he's a natural three. I know that contradicts a lot of people, but I look at him, Obi Toppin, he's 6'8", 6'9", and he's 225, and he's athletic. He goes down the court. He's fast. He's athletic. He can jump out the building. I mean, did you see all those highlight dunks? The 360s, the in between the legs. He's not scared of contact. He has a post game. He has a jump shot. At the end, I look at Obi Toppin as a three. And not to mention, he can put the ball on the floor. So what are we really talking about? So you got that going for you. And then the free agents we went out and signed. This is what I'm really proud of as a Knicks fan, is we didn't go out and sign a washed up Gordon Hayward. We didn't pull a Michael Jordan. This guy Michael Jordan went out and signed Gordon Hayward for 4 years, $120 million. That's a Knicks move. That's when the Knicks, that's a Knicks move that holds the team back. I mean, for real. People complain that we didn't get Gordon Hayward. What the fuck is Gordon Hayward going to do for us? Is Gordon Hayward going to send us to the playoffs? No. Is Gordon Hayward going to come in and be like the best player on our team? No. At the end of the day, what is Gordon Hayward do for us? So like people out here complain that we get Gordon Hayward. You want to pay Gordon Hayward $120 million? You want to go out and pay Gordon Hayward $120 million? At the end of the day, come on now. At the end of the day, the future is bright in New York. We went out and signed Alex Burke, a player that scored 15 points per game before. I got a nice jump shot and is athletic and can move up and down the floor. Like I said, we went out and signed another solid big man, another solid defensive big man, Nerlens Noel. I went out and re-signed Elfrid Payton, which I like because I actually think Elfrid Payton is nice. He right now, truth be told, Elfrid Payton was our best point guard. But my thing is, Dennis Smith, he's more of a scorer. And Frank Ntilikina can't playmake like Elfrid Payton. Elfrid Payton is our best playmaking point guard. Plus, he has defense. So, I like that re-signing. Like I said, we got Austin Rivers, who's athletic. And Austin Rivers is one of the most athletic players in the league. And he can move up and down the floor. Has a solid jump shot. Getting him for 3 years for $10 million. That's a gut move. We went out and signed one of the best on-ball defenders in the NBA, Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. I mean, what we complaining for? I mean, for real, what are we complaining for? We're not signing any players for long, big contracts. We went out and we got a top three player in the draft. And we getting solid veterans that can play their role. Nerlens Noel, when Money Mitch comes out, you defend the rim. Austin Rivers, you come in as that 6'7 man, you put the ball in the hoop, and you run up and down the floor. Use your athleticism. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist, when we had to play, a Jason Tatum, or we got to go out and play a Kevin Durant, we going to send Michael Kidd-Gilchrist to go guard him for 40 minutes. Everybody got their role. Alex Burke comes in, he hits up spot up jumpers. When RJ Barrett comes off the floor and RJ Barrett needs a break, you give Alex Burke the ball, he can do a little bit with the ball in his hand. At the end of the day, players know their role. And that's not something that we could have said for the past 2 years when we had freaking Phil Jackson running the team and whatnot. At the end, they players start to know their role. We got solidified head coach. We got top five head coach in the league. At the end, they players know their role. So it's like, at the end of the day, how could I be upset with Leon Rose? Leon Rose has done phenomenal. Leon Rose has done phenomenal since he's gotten the building. He hasn't went out and traded for Chris Paul. He didn't go out. He didn't go out and sign Gordon Hayward for $140 million for the next 4 years. At the end of the day, this guy Leon Rose has done spectacular work. And not to mention, we still got a young group that's trying to prove themselves. Can Frank Ntilikina develop a jump shot? Can Frank Ntilikina develop some playmaking skills? Can Kevin Knox show any promise? I just got Kevin Knox at 6 points per game last year. Can Kevin Knox be any what of Jason Tatum? Can he show any resemblance of Jason Tatum? At the end of the day, y'all, we got Dennis Smith, who, you know, is super talented. He just needs to be consistent. At the end of the day, we got talent on the floor. We're young, and nobody has any big contracts. Outside Julius Randle getting paid his $18 million, who is getting paid $10 million on this team? Who's out here getting paid half of what Julius Randle is? Alright, so it's like outside Julius Randle contract, who else is getting paid? At the end of the day, y'all, the future is bright in New York. This is the best time to be a Knicks fan. It really is. It's a really excited time to be a Knicks fan. RJ Barrett is going to take that sophomore year leap. RJ Barrett is going to have an all-star year next year. Same for Money Mitch. Money Mitch is going to prove that he's the black Rudy Gobert. Obi Toppin is going to come in and give you 16 and 10. At the end of the day, the future is bright in New York. So, you know, as a Knicks fan, I couldn't have been prouder for how this all season's went out, man. I know Knicks fans, they all negative and they're all like this. We need superstars. Why we didn't get Giannis? Listen, I don't care about that. At the end of the day, it's building with who you got. We got RJ Barrett in the fucking building. That's a future superstar right there. The future of the NBA right there. And at the end of the day, it's just surrounding RJ with as much talent as possible without the big contracts. So it's like at the end of the day, this all season went perfectly, man. This all season went perfectly. I couldn't ask for more. Like I said, I couldn't ask for more as a Knicks fan. And at the end of the day, the ball is in RJ hand. The ball is in RJ hand. So hopefully we can get NBA season rolling. I'm going to keep it a buck. I haven't been keeping up with how the NBA is going to do their thing because we need deep in NFL season. Right now, we speak about Russell Wilson and Brady and freaking Big Ben. That's what we're speaking about right now. That's the vibes we want. But once NBA season rolls around, once the Knicks get ready to rock, you know I'll be covering more Knicks content weekly, daily. It's what we do. So go ahead and hit that like button. All right? For real. With the amount of Knicks fans that subscribe to this channel, I should be having about at least 10 to 15 likes on each of it. For real. Real talk. But that's all you got to say, man. That's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm from number one. And I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. Shout out my Bloods, they're still bloodin', nigga. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas. When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see you another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.